a woman flew through the air on a flying trapeze with the greatest of ease. This was a while ago, a long time ago. Let's pick a date. December 25th, 1897. Newspaper accounts. Charmion and her famous trapeze disrobing act debuted at the Foster and Mial Variety Theater in New York City. 1897, when fashion and society dictated that women wear at least 30 layers of undergarments. The length, shape, and cut of a dress designed so that an onlooker would not catch an immodest glance of an ankle, calf, knee, thigh, whoops. We wouldn't get the right to vote for another 20-some years. And dress reform was a hot item on the suffragette ticket. Do you know what a leotard is? A thing dancers wear? Do you know where it comes from? There was this French aerialist by the name of Jules Leotard. He invented the death-defying flying trapeze act. He also invented the costume for trapeze. He needed a costume that wouldn't encumber the athletics. He also needed something that would display a hard-working body. Voila! The leotard. Years after the invention of the act and the costume, Charmion adopted it for her flying trapeze disrobing act. His actions are graceful, the girls he doth please, my love. Trapeze. The act of hanging off of, pulling oneself up on a wooden dowel attached to two ropes, connected to a support system, suspending the acrobat way, way, way above the ground. When she was a little girl, her father took her to the park to fly a kite. But she cried because the kite could fly and not she. There's so many stories. There's, and the, oh, yeah. I'll start here. Charmion was born Laverie Cooper in 1875 in Sacramento, California. But let me tell you about her discovery and how she changed her name to Charmion. Okay, it's January 1897, and there's this famous impresario, agent, manager, world-renowned. His name is Stoltz, and he has just disembarked from a failed Australian tour of his act, the Flying Something or Other Brothers. And he's landed in San Francisco flat broke. So he holds himself up in the Edison Hotel, drinking away his misery, when there's a knock on the door, and a bellhop, bring, with a little hat, bring, bring, and a card on a silver platter. A Mr. Delaney to see you, sir. He wants to talk to you about his wife's act. Okay, now who is this Delaney, and why is he in the story? Well, Delaney was wore for good luck. And he had it on today because this was a very special occasion. He was going to meet the famous impresario, Mr. Stoltz. The lady says, "You've got to meet my wife. Her name's Laverie Vallee. That's me, Delaney. She's Laverie, my wife. She's a trapeze artist. She's performing tonight. She is a solo trapeze artist, and she's really, really good. Well, either the red sweater worked or Delaney was very convincing, but Stoltz agreed to see the performance. On his way there, he passes a store with advertisements for corsets. He gets an idea. His next big headlining act. So he sees Laverie, and she is really, really good. And he explains his idea to Laverie and Delaney, and they love it. Okay, nobody has much money, so Stoltz borrows some lingerie from a barkeep friend of his and pulls some strings to get Laverie on a variety show act. They are a hit. So Stoltz calls New York, Costa and beyond. They love the idea. They book her sight unseen. They give her a contract for 23 weeks at $1,000 a week. This is true. I did some serious scholarly research. But they don't have any money for railroad fare. So Stoltz sends a telegram. No money for railroad fare. Stop. Please forward. Stop. Coaster and Bial send back. Railroad fare only for foreign artists. Stop. Stoltz. She's French. Stop. Name's Charmion. And history is made. The little girl from Sacramento who cried because of a kite became Charmion. She even adopted a French accent. Je m'appelle Charmion, trapeze disrobing act. She was one of the most highly paid stars on the vaudeville circuit. Charmion, c'est la vie. I'll tell you more stories tomorrow night. Au revoir.